are going to be looking at actually taking out some mouth clicks from a recording. Now, this is a recording of an interview, so it's dialogue close mic'd, and you're going to hear a lot of kind of sounds.
Born and raised there, moved out in 84, moved to Los Angeles. Born and raised there, moved out in 84.
Now, you can actually see those click sounds are corresponding with these kind of vertical lines, because those are just bursts of noise. That's what a click really is. All we need to do is open up the D-click module. It's going to reset it back to its default. I'm going to set it to multiband, because why not? Now, first of all, we can hit clicks only. Now, this is actually what it's going to be taking out. This is the sound of the click. Kind of gross, right? And this is actually, if you were to process it out with just those, that's what those clicks actually look like. Those are the mouth noises. But I don't want to do that. I want to get rid of them. So we're going to process.
Born and raised there, moved out in 84, moved to Los Angeles.
And you can see as well, these vertical lines are all those clicks beforehand. And then, that's what we're actually removing. And that is dealing with mouth clicks.
Wow. Is that D-click also in the standard? Or?
Yes, absolutely. D-click is both in standard and advanced. There's been some new DSP in RX4 to specifically target mouth noises. It's always been a function, but there's new DSP in it specifically targeting that as an issue.
It's time to upgrade.
Yes.
What have you guys done differently with the denoise module over the last version?
Denoise, so one of the big things with this is that the dialogue denoiser, the real-time adaptive dialogue denoiser, which was previously only in RX3 Advanced, is now in RX4 Standard. It was very popular with videographers and other people who just need something to easily throw on and be like, yep, denoise. That is now in RX4 Standard. Absolutely.
What makes it uniquely suitable for dialogue denoising?
So it is actually tuned to the human voice. And the awesome thing with it is that it is, again, real time, it's adaptive. So like if right now we're recording us in this and then half a second later we're outside by traffic, it's going to adapt to that noise. You don't need to change anything. There's no, like, you're not telling it to learn functionality. Like this actually is the dialogue denoiser up on the screen right now. You'll see that we have two controls. We have reduction and threshold. I almost never touch the threshold because I rarely need to.
Born and raised there, moved out.
And you're just adjusting the amount of reduction, and that's all that happens.
Now, there are some other like noise reduction plugins that I used to use before the RX3. Mm-hmm. Waves, for example, that introduced some artifacts to the dialogue, to the narration. If I went too, you know, too harsh, let's say.
Sure.
So how far can you really push this thing with?
Pretty far. So if you push it really hard, you will be able to get some artifacts. The best way to go about it is giving it a few passes at a lower setting. That's the way to get the most transparent sound. Let's say you're in a really, actually, I have a very extreme example of noise. Let's see where it is here. Yes, so this is the file. Right now, I'm in Pro Tools. I'm going to send this over to RX4 through RX4 Connect. Now, in this example, there's a lot of machine noise going on in the background. That's a lot of noise.
And I'm standing on the International Space Station!
So, a lot of noise. The dialogue denoiser, again, without learning anything, let's see what it can do. So, preview.
And I'm standing on the International Space Station!
So, pretty good. You'll notice we are getting a little bit of gating, so a little bit of noise. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the spectral denoiser. And in this instance, I'm going to select the noise. I'm going to tell it to learn so it knows what the noise looks like. Two things we can do to really make sure that we're not going to get any kind of like watery artifacts. So, first, I'm going to delink this reduction slider. So now we have separate reduction controls for tonal versus noisy content. Now you can see these horizontal lines running. This is very tonal noise. So I'm going to push tonal even all the way. Why not? Push noisy a little bit less. Another thing I'm going to do is turn on the reduction curve. Now, a lot of artifacts are going to be created around kind of like sibilant sounds. So I'm going to create up in the high mids there, less reduction there. So whatever. Let's preview this and see how we're doing.
And I'm standing on the International Space Station.
so I'm going to bypass this preview.
And I'm standing on the International Space Station!
So there's a number of tools that we have that we can actually use to make sure that we're not getting those kinds of artifacts. And again, I just gave it one intense pass. You'd get a much better result if you just gave it a few light passes.
That's awesome. Thank you.
Hey, thank you.
Absolutely, no problem.
Well, it's just about the end of the AES 137 show here in LA, but it wouldn't be complete without running into a friend from the voiceover world, and guess who flew out just for this show? Well, maybe not, but actually I got right here with me, Anthony Mendez.
What's up, everybody? George is trying to make me spend money over here.
Exactly. But we had a great time. There was a lot of amazing stuff. I hope you enjoyed the coverage. This is George Whittam reporting for Whittam's World.